So now I'm just swishing my brush around in there, and I'm gonna drag it on the side of the cup a little bit. Try not to flick your neighbor. Okay, so now dab it on the paper towel so there's not too much water. And I'm gonna take my blue, beautiful blue, and I'm just gonna swish all the way across, and oh my goodness, is that ever dramatic. Again, don't panic, it will all make sense. Okay, just go all the way across, all the way across, do your side. Do your side. If you're doing the sides, you really don't have to, but if you want to hang it when you get home, and you don't want to have to put a frame on it, makes it look more finished rather than having the white edges. All right, so we're bringing the blue down a little bit. Bringing the blue down a little bit. Okay, now your red, let it dry it up a little while we've been doing the blue. That's okay. We're gonna take some more red. I'm gonna start at the bottom of the blue, and we're gonna get a nice purple or violet color. And we're gonna gradually bring that down to meet up with our red. And you can go back and forth and back and forth, and you'll get different shades of purple depending on how much red is in it and how much blue is in it. And then you do your sides as well, and you can, it doesn't have to be perfect, it's just to give it a little bit of continuity at the edges. I'm going to take some more red, because as I was going around and looking at all the beautiful paintings that all the artists in here are creating this evening, mine got a little dry. That's fine, so I'm fixing that right now. This is something that happens when you choose to blend paint on the canvas, especially with acrylics. With oils, you have a lot more time because they take a long time to dry. But that's okay, you can just keep adding paint. And it still looks seamless. Now, if you want more of a seam, then you don't have to blend as much. If you want less of a seam, you can blend more. I'm going to add a little bit of white, just in a couple of places. Here. And I'm going to blend that in. Now, the white is going to give it a little bit of a sort of a misty or clouds. I'm going to do the edge. I'm going to bring my white. And you don't have to blend the white perfectly. You can kind of leave them. You can put clouds in here if you like. If you're a fan of clouds in your paintings, they can be tricky, but you can go for it. I'm going to stick to the plan. I don't want anybody to get overwhelmed. So, here we go. Blending in my white. And you don't have to use white. If you regret using the white, you can wait till it dries, and then you can go back over it with the color. So, excuse me. Now I'm going to do black. Put my black way up here at the top. And I'm going to do my top. The very top edge. Well, I've got just the black on my brush before I mix it with the blue to get that nice midnight blue color. Okay. Carrying on with my arches, my arcs, I should say. Okay, need more Now, black is one of the colors that you might run out of just because we're going to use so much of it in the mountains and the trees and the birds. So please feel free to get more if you need more. And you don't have to have, I didn't do as much black in that one, and that's fine. You can have as much or as little of any color as you like. Now I'm going to get my blue, and I'm going to start at the black edge. If anybody needs me to slow down, please yell out, slow down. I will not be offended. I will just slow down. And you might not be the only one that is wanting that. So you might be speaking for more people than just you. Don't be shy. We're not here to be shy. We're here to have fun. We're here to create. Here to relax. That's why you're not supposed to get stressed out or panic. Panic is not very relaxing. Okay, so I'm happy. I'm happy with my colors. So now I'm gonna come around, see how everybody's doing. I'm gonna give that some time to dry before we do our mountains and our trees and our birds. So as you can see mine, I painted this one. And this one doesn't really look exactly like that one, and that's fine. they're all going to be a little bit different, especially when you're blending the colors on the canvas. It's kind of hard to do an exact replica of something. I think you can tell I used a bit more white in this one. And that's that was just the preference at the time. So right now I'm just going with more straight color. And I can see that you're all doing lovely work. And so I'm gonna start in mixing my color for the background now. If you want, you can keep working on your background. The mountain is not, it's not specific. So you can take your time with your background. Don't take too long. If you blend it too much, you're just going to end up with a bunch of grays, and it won't be as interesting. So try to keep it organic. If you keep going back, and changing it, I don't think you might never be totally happy with it. But when you see. When you get all of this done on top of it, it's going to look awesome. So, we're going to take our medium brush, and you may name it if you like. You can tell me the name. We can all call it the same name, or we can just call it medium brush. So, we need black, we need white, we need red for this background mountain. So if you need any of those colors, now's the time to grab some. I'm doing okay with my colors, so I'm going to just pull some of my black away from my pile of black. I'm going to pull some of my white, and you don't have to mix it completely. It's all right if you've got sort of streaks of black and streaks of white. That's totally okay. And you can make it as dark or as light or as red as you want. I'm happy with mine. Now what we're going to do is we're going to start that mountain about a third of the way up the canvas. So if you want, you can do the edge before you even start on the front. You don't have to worry about doing it after. So about a third of the way up. There we go. And if you want to put it higher, that's fine. But if you're going to do this, you don't want to go too far up because you're going to take away from your tree. So just gonna start mine about there, and I'm just going to keep my brush flat on the canvas. And it doesn't have to be rocky. That's up to you. I'm just going to get a little bit more pink. Some of my edges here are a little bit, they're not sharp. I kind of want them to be a little bit sharp. And then you just spill it in. And you can, I kind of like it because it's a mountain and it has little rocky, different rocky sections probably. I'm not too concerned about it looking completely uniform. It's not really the look that I want on mine, but again, that is completely your call. So in the first one I did, I took some extra white and some extra black, red, and I sort of blended them on the canvas so it looks a little bit less uniform. So that's the look that I like. So I'm just going to grab a little tiny bit of black, a little tiny bit of white, and a little tiny bit of red. And then I'm just going to make some strokes in here. I'm going to leave some white bits and some gray bits, and different shades. Need a little bit more. And I'm just going to leave those a little bit rough. And that's all that's to the background mountain. And the background mountain in this one has a different shape than my background mountain in this one. And that's totally fine. So we want to leave that